And here we are at Zolder for round three of the Octane Online Racing Sprint Series. This is the North America Split Blue. Once again, racing in the Aston Martin for this season. Skipped doing a race recap of round two. That was at Bathurst, and it was a little off pace and alone most of the time, so it was a bit boring. Ended up P9. So coming into Zolder, I think I'm top five, and this is going to be round race number two of Super Sprint format. So in the Super Sprints, there's 2 30-minute races back to back. The first one has regular qualifying, and the second one is a reverse grid of the top 12, and then everybody else qualifies again. So I bottled qualifying really badly and wasn't able to do any overtaking, so we're starting this one P4 thanks to the reverse grid. So here we are, a little out of line because of that Porsche in front in P2, so automatically going to lose some spots off the start, but here we are, green flag, go into turn one. Everything's looking pretty safe. We'll drop in the back, going into turn two here. So, as expected, lost a spot to the Lexus, so down into P5. We're going side by side with the Porsche. So I'm gonna stick my nose in here, we'll go three wide. Who's got the biggest balls into the first chicane? Porsche backs out. Lexus completely misses the brakes. And so he's gotta let me by since he cut the track, but he's not gonna. So we go side by side into the second chicane, and I just kind of e-sport elbow my way through up into P3. That's a solid first lap. And now everyone is slowed down as we're getting picked up by the safety car due to a giant crash further back in the field. So we'll do a quick lap behind the safety car, so speed this up a bit. Coming around. Down through chicane two. Actually have to do two laps behind the safety car, so there was issues with people overtaking under the safety car, so they needed to sort the field back out. So here we go, back around, everyone getting even colder tires. This taught me I really hate safety cars. Restarts are so brutal. You basically instantly grain your tires. So, safety car peels away, and we're getting ready for the restart. And back to green flag. Audi challenging for P1 into turn two. So it looks like top five cars getting a little bit of separation from the group. Getting some solid air over the Yeet chicane while trying to put as much pressure as possible on this Audi, since it is an unstable nightmare over that chicane. I'm just basically gonna push and hope he messes up. Drift into the first corner. Porsche tries to sneak by on the inside. He backs out of it though, so I can take the inside line. Porsche is still side by side with the Lexus. And he gets it done just into the fast right. But now I got a 1.1 second gap to the Audi to make back up. Thanks to the gold tire mistake, but tires should finally start to be back up to where they should be, so we can start doing hot laps again. What lap time is the leader doing? He did a 29.277. Audi in P2 did a 29.3. And with my giant mistake, I ended up doing a 30.1. So that needs to get a lot better. Top five cars continue to put a gap on the rest of the field. That's up to 3 seconds. So 29.5. Peter did a 29.2. Audi did a 29.1. So lost a little bit of ground again. Gap's up to 1.4. A little onboard while we try and catch the Audi. Oh, but the Audi does Audi things in the chicane. So gap to P2 goes to 2 seconds now, but gap to P2 is now only a half a second. Audi gets wide in turn one. Gonna close right up on him. Try and get under, making the pass, still there, each little touch, and pass complete. So now 3 seconds to close down on P1. Raining tires are a little drifty still. Beautiful second chicane. Gap to the Audi has gone up 3/10 already, so it's almost a full second now. Yeah, 29.148, that's much better, even with a little drift mistake. Gap to P1 is down to 2.5. 28.9. Made up a few more tenths that lap. Gap's down to 1.7. That was probably a track cut. I think I ended up getting three in this race. Caused me to slow down the last couple of laps just to make absolutely certain I didn't get a drive through. Another 28.9, so gap is still going down. It's at 1.4 now. Gap to the Audi behind has gone up to 1.6, so no threat there. Deep on that last chicane. Yeah, so I ended up with a 29.1. Pace is still good though. Gap is 1.5. Nice 28.6. Took a nice bite out of the lead, got back 3 tenths, so down to 1.2. Oh, and he jumps off-road. Gonna take a run around the outside. we're through into P1. Not getting away too fast, still only 7/10. Looks like Landry gets into the final chicane a little bit faster than me, so he's close back up to 6/10. And doing a 29.1. Dornelis got by the Audis, so we got an all Aston Martin podium currently. And he's probably going to be hard charging, but he's got 3.8 seconds to make up. Still doing high 28s, so that's solid pace to stay out in front. Gap to P2 hasn't gone anywhere though. On a back marker, he charges through the chicane. I think being distracted by him is where I got my last warning, because it looked like I cut too much of the second chicane there. Ferrari goes into the pits, so no need to blue flag him. 28.9, still on a solid pace. Extending the gap to P2 to 1 second. Aston flies over that chicane so easily. It's really the only thing that saves it on this track. There's so many slow corner exits, you're usually stuck in turbo lag for excruciating amounts of time. So being able to yeet the chicane pretty hardcore is probably the only thing that keeps it doing competitive times. Yeah, so after taking that third warning, I backed off a little bit, so Landry's able to catch back up. He's only 6 tenths behind again. 4 tenths now, after doing a 29.6. Here we are coming along, tick the checkered flag. Aston Martin 1-2-3, so my first win of this championship thanks to the reverse grid. I mean, win's a win, I guess, so I'm happy with that. And on to the next round.